Well, that's all on the Erie Canal. And was it 15 miles on the Erie Canal? Okay. I got a mule, her name is Sal, something like that. But right now, we're not talking about mules or manure, but we're going to be talking about composting and recycling. Tell us a little bit about what you're doing. You got a compost fair for the whole family.
That's right. So as the recycling educator for Schenectady County, we're always looking for interesting ways to engage the community with environmental education. So that's why we've put together the compost fair coming up in just a few weeks. It's going to be over in our greenhouse facilities that are managed by Cooperative Extension. Yeah. That's right. Have you ever been to our greenhouse facilities?
I've driven by it, but I haven't been in there. But I think I should.
Yeah, we're tucked away right by the tennis court.
Yeah, I know exactly where it is.
In Central Park, we have an urban farm there that we run like a CSA program out of.
Not far from Music Haven.
Not far from Music Haven, just a stone's throw. And we obviously have the greenhouse facilities and the classroom. So the compost fair is going to be held right there at the Sustainable Living Center. And we've partnered with probably about a dozen different local organizations who are gonna be doing outreach education about backyard composting and soil science and recycling. We'll even have some folks there doing education about how to reduce food waste before it ever becomes garbage, how to properly store food, you know, really looking at
that's really important.
You know, recycling as a whole. Like I always tell people that composting is not just something that gardeners do. You know, it's not you don't have to be a gardener, you don't have to be a scientist to make compost. It's like the next step to being a really better recycler. And it's so easy to make compost, and that's why we want to share that with the community.
I have compost and I use it all the time. I have actually one that we built and that we just put in and throw a few leaves in and mix it up and kind of keep it going.
Absolutely. Yeah. And when you learn just a couple tips and tricks, composting is a lot less intimidating when you just know the basics to it.
I don't think you have to add worms to it. But although you're working with...
You don't always know. Yeah.
You're working with Bisoil or...
Bisoil Farm will be there. Oh, geez, we have so many friends that are coming out and doing education. The Friends of the Greenhouse is doing a wonderful raffle, so you can come and win all kinds of prizes if you're interested in
gardening. Will you be selling plants
The Master Gardeners will be there.
Okay.
They had a big plant sale coming up that had passed, but they'll be there doing soil testing, which is really exciting. So if you are a gardener and you want to have your soil like evaluated, they'll be able to give you recommendations for how to best do that, depending on what it is that you're trying
to
grow.
Yeah, because soil has different pHs, and so you need to have the right kind of a mix to get...
Absolutely.
And then, of course, many times you have to rotate your crops a little bit. Of course, we're not talking about farming, but even a garden in your own yard, you might want to rotate a little
bit. So if you have questions about gardening, you want to get your soil tested, you can come out and get education like that.
You have a show coming up, too.
Yeah, so that's really exciting. So part of the compost fair...
And we have photos, we'll bring those photos up.
Yeah, put the photos up. So as part of the compost fair, we're doing this educational performance, Dirt, The Secret Life of Soil, is performed by Arm of the Sea Theater. Arm of the Sea Theater is a performance art ensemble from Saugerties, New York, and they do visual arts and storytelling and just puppet magic. It's really wonderful. So this show is going to be on the Music Haven stage, and it's going to close out the compost fair at 2:30 on July 28th.
And plenty of chairs. We know that all those chairs are new out there.
Yes, I hope that we do fill the space. This show is free to come out. We've been able to work with a lot of local organizations who really support environmental sustainability, and they've helped contribute to this performance. So I want to thank all of our sponsors for getting involved with the fair.
And this is a free event.
It's all free, and that's the beautiful thing. You know, it's free to come to the fair. It's free to go to this special performance art show, and we're giving away hundreds of free prizes. Price Chopper has donated reusable grocery bags, so to reduce plastic bag waste, we're going to be giving reusable bags. We have lots of prizes at the fair that kids could win. There's face painting, there's games for kids to learn about soil science and composting, and it's really for all ages.
It's on a Saturday.
Saturday, yeah, all morning. Come early and get to meet everyone and see all the wonderful things that the community's doing to educate about recycling, composting, wonderful. Food waste, I mean, it's a big issue. So we're really energized to inspire people about that.
And I don't know what you can do about restaurants. I hate to see all that food. I hope they sell it to pig farms or something, or do something with it, because
absolutely,
I hate to see it go into the trash, and I have seen it just dumped into plastic bags.
Yeah, I mean, from every level of the food chain, you really see farmers who are losing food because it doesn't meet the specifications that the grocery store wants.
But there's many stores are now putting up a bruised or not so ugly fruit.
Ugly fruit. Go ahead and buy the ugly fruit.
It's still quality.
They are delicious and they need a home too. So.
And I know where they're going to go.
Absolutely. And I wanted to mention too, because we were talking so much about volunteering today on your show, this event, there's so many wonderful volunteers behind this event. I just wanted to thank them. We have a lot of volunteers in our program through the Master Composter, Master Recycler training that we do at Cooperative Extension, and they're running workshops at the fair, they're doing composting demonstrations, they're coming up with games for kids, you know, they're really, really involved, and I love having volunteers that are really energized to teach people about these
issues. And dedicated.
Yeah.
And you work with Cornell as well.
Yes, yeah. I'm out of Cornell Cooperative Extension, and we're funded by Schenectady County with the support of grants through the DEC and the Environmental Protection Fund, and we're out there on the front lines. You'll see me at the farmers markets and at other events, and I have a recycling hotline if anyone has questions about recycling.
Just bring everything to her house.
Yeah, I recycle everything. So
I mean, too, I'm a recycler. Repurpose a lot of stuff too, because it's
so important.
Yeah, it's so important to do that. But check out the fair. It's coming up in July, on July 28th, and we'll remind you again if you get my regular MailChimp that I send out every week. I do list all the free events in the area, including all of the Music Haven and composting. So we do try and get that information out to every one of our guests, or our viewers anyway. And if you want to, just email me and I'll get you on the list. So thanks so much, Angelina.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for having me on the show, Ann.
We're going to take another quick break. And when we come back, we're going to end up this show with Jerry Corton and the J Street Band. They're going to be rocking and rolling right out our door.